Okay, everyone. This pretty good sized box just arrived from Amazon on Sunday. Let's get it open, see what's in there. All right, lots of bubble wrap. I guess it's a type of bubble wrap. Okay, there's another little box down in here. It gets in there pretty tight. It's wedged. All right. Add it to the side. Look at that. It's not a huge box. I actually thought this was going to be a little bit larger than what it is, but let's get it open, see what's in there. Oh, look at that. Looks like the paint was rubbing off of the hatchet head there onto the box, but we'll see. What's all this? Okay, they got a piece of rope twine there. And you get the little leather key ring that has the Swedish flag on it, because this whole setup is made in Sweden. And you get a little book that looks like it's tied into there. Okay, I can slide it out, I guess. There we go. It's got some raised lettering on it. HB for Hults Bruk. And I think it's just the history of Hults Bruk. Back in 1697, I believe they were making these type of nails. And they give you one. Give me one second here. Okay, in, I believe it was 1697, Hults Bruk was making nails, square nails, if you see that, for ships back in the day. And I heard this a long time ago, before they started making nails out of those long rolls of wire that goes through the machine and gets clipped. Then another machine like flattens the head. They used to make them square. And I did hear once that a square nail exerts force better in like four different directions. And actually holds tighter than a modern round nail. But I heard that we switched to the round nails strictly for speed of manufacturing. So that's a little tidbit of info there. Even though this is a modern version of the old one, it's pretty cool that they hooked you up with that. It goes into these little hoops on this key ring. And that's how they got their start. And this is the anniversary edition. 325 years in 2022. 325 year anniversary. And this was their little celebration hatchet. And I just got one. Now, Hultafors of Sweden ended up purchasing Hults Bruk. And now, even though they're still made and they still use their Hults Bruk stamp, it's actually owned by Hultafors now. But it does come with a nice leather axe mask, and it also has the Swedish flag on it. It's got like, looks like kind of like brass, kind of bronze rivets, and the snap there. It does have a wilt in it. It's not super thick, but it is wilted. Looks like a little weep hole to let water drain out. It's stitched pretty decent. Just a standard okay axe mask, but I'm just taking in, I'm sitting here looking at this. Looks really nice. It's got a mirror polished edge on that, like a mirror polished convex edge. That looks really nice. It's probably heat treated. up pretty far. I would say somewhere in this vicinity. It's got a hickory handle. It does have a little runoff, but it, so from what I'm seeing, it looks like a decent hickory handle. I mean, that's pretty straight grain. If you can see that through the red paint there, if it's showing, I mean, that's darn near perfect. But where it was rubbing in the box, that's where some of that green paint was coming from. But yeah, really nice. It's got some weight to it. It says it is, I think it says 0.6. So I think that, or is that 0.8? Yeah, it's pretty hard to see the way it's stamped. 1 1/4, there it is. And it is made in Sweden. Painted green, has a sticker on it that's black and gold. Yep, the anniversary edition. Oh, it looks like it's hung pretty nice. It's got a wood wedge and a steel barrel wedge. And it doesn't look like the wood is too beat up there. It actually looks really well done. You can see there's just hardly no gappage at all. I think that little spot right there is all there is. So yeah, looks like they did a pretty good job on this. And that mirror polished edge, isn't that sick? God, that looks so cool. Nice and fat up here at the top. You can choke up on it. Use it for more for carving. I do want to get some measurements on this. Okay, it turns out that is a 6. It's 0.6, which is about 22 ounces. Okay, you're looking at 15 inches overall, and the width of the pole up here is about 2 1/8 that direction. It is about 7/8 wide, almost a full inch wide. It has about a 3 1/4 inch cutting edge. And the axe head length is about 5 7/8, just about 6 inches long. So you're looking at 959 grams. £2, 1.9 ounce. And with the mask, throw that on there, 202.7. And back to grams. Okay, there it is with its mask put back on, and it stays on really good. It's not gonna slip off or anything. And the nail is back in the key ring there. It even has like a nice matching color hoop there for your keys. I'm just like, I don't know if I want to use this and beat it up, though. I think I'd rather just keep it nice, because that's pretty neat. I definitely am going to use this, I'm sure, though. And as far as the steel goes, it always, everything I look at just says Swedish steel, or like high quality Swedish steel. So I'm not sure exactly where it comes in, but maybe it'll say in the booklet here. I haven't I just unboxed it. I haven't had a chance to look it over yet. But for size comparisons, this is the new Joker knife I just picked up the other day. And it's the 6.5 Nomad. It's their biggest knife so far, I believe. And you can see that would be a great bushcraft set to go out to the woods with there. This is it beside my heavily, heavily used Spyderco. Now, most people I know wouldn't take two big chopper blades out to the woods at the same time, but I would. Check that out. The Ontario RTAC 2. And a camp hatchet. You could get a lot done. I highly recommend a saw, though. Never underestimate a folding saw or some type of saw when you go out to the woods. Well, that's about the perfect setup right there. You wouldn't need a whole lot more than that. I think the only thing you could add to it that might make it a little better would maybe be this. The Swiss Champ 33 Swiss Army knife. Like that. Would be a heck of a survival slash bushcraft kit when you're out in the woods. Got a sheet of printer paper here. And this is the hatchet right out of the package. And I know that an axe or hatchet being paper cutting sharp isn't that important, but that mirror polished edge, it looks so cool. I want to see if it's as sharp as it looks. Oh, jeez. Yes, yes it is. Man, that is nice. Look at that. That's like a freaking scalpel. Wonder if I could do little feathers with it. Yes, I could. Man, that is awesome. Definitely get yourself one of these. Well, I think I about covered it for this review. Everything I could think of. Excellent looking hickory handle. Like, they picked out the best handle they had, I think. You get a really cool keychain. Leather keychain with a replica nail of how they got their business started. Cool, cool hatchet. Mirror polished, razor sharp convex edge. And just from what I've felt of it, just holding it here, it's a little slick. It's a little slicker where the red paint is, but like the wood feels a little more grippy up here. But yeah, nice and straight. If I could get this to focus. Yep, there we go. Looks very symmetrical. Really well done, hung beautifully. I actually have some camiform tape arriving over the next couple days. I got red to match this. And then I wanted to have like an overstrike guard up here and just something affordable for now. Leather looks the best, of course. But I ended up getting some orange like camiform tape. It's that self-adhesive stuff that doesn't leave a residue. And I think that a little bit of it right here for overstriking, orange next to green, might look pretty cool. Might look like crap. I won't know until it arrives, but yeah. I was gonna put green up there, but then I thought it might be too much green. Just red up there would look good with this red, though. But then you'd only have a little a little space with no variation. So I'm going to try to put a little piece of orange up here and see what that looks like. But ultimately, I might put leather anyhow. But it was just something I was tossing around in my head. Pretty nice looking hatchet. Really top notch. They have a Hults Bruk Yoniker that I want to pick up too. It's got a huge mirror polished edge on it. Well, I mean, not huge, but a bigger amount of it, like width-wise, is kind of mirror polished. And if you get the Hultafors version, since they own them now, it's called the Angles John, I think, or Angle John, if I'm pronouncing that right. Angles John or Angles John. But it's the exact same hatchet. It's a little cheaper. But it even has the Hults Bruk stamp on the head, so you're basically getting the same thing. I heard if you get the Hults Bruk version, it's like the fit and finish is a little better. And there might be a few little extras. Whereas the Hultafors version, Hultafors USA, I think is just the fit and finish is, it's almost identical. I don't think you're really sacrificing anything, whatever way you want to go. And of course, Hultafors makes the money. So no matter which one you purchase, so it's up to you which one you like better. But yeah, before this video posts, that camiform tape should arrive. So I'll throw that in this video too, so you can see that. But that's all I've got for today. Well, I guess this is the final update. This is it with some orange, like camiform tape wrapped on the handle. And it gives it excellent grip. And then I have a nice thick amount of it up here at the top as a overstrike guard. And it also gives you extra grip when you choke up on it. But it's just an idea. You don't have to do that. You could get a like an old school leather cover. And that's if I decide to even use this hatchet, because it is such a gorgeous hatchet. I hate to beat it up since it is an anniversary edition. But I ordered red for down here of the camiform tape, and I had orange for up here. But of course, the post office lost the red one because they were two separate deliveries. The orange got delivered, the red got marked as delivered, but was never delivered. So, I mean, seems like one out of every three orders gets lost anymore. It's just ridiculous. But this is that type of tape I used. I got it off of Amazon. It's like a medical tape, same as camiform tape. It's that self-adhesive, but there's no glue on it. It just sticks to itself, and then you can peel it off and reuse it multiple times. It does not hold up forever. Like if it gets too wet or too hot, you might have to remove it and then replace it with some fresh new wrap. But it's really cheap and it works awesome. So you could do a lot worse than that. It gives you super good grip. But yeah, that's, I just wanted to show that before I ended the video.
This is Joe Doomsday, signing out.